He is a sign of the hour. He is a sign of the hour. Have no doubt about it. But follow me. This is a straight path. It is clear that the word he in this verse refers to the prophet Jesus. That is because the preceding verses also speak of Jesus and use the adverb he to refer to him. He is only a servant on whom we bestowed our blessing and whom we made an example for the tribe of Israel. Indeed, almost all commentators on the Quran and great Islamic scholars agree that the He in these verses is the Prophet Jesus. Therefore, this verse is a clear indication that the Prophet Jesus will come back to earth at the end times. That is because the Prophet Jesus lived approximately 6 centuries before the revelation of the Quran. Consequently, we cannot interpret his first coming as a sign of the doomsday. The meaning of the verse is that the Prophet Jesus will return to earth in the end times. In other words, the final period of time before doomsday, and that this will be a portent of doomsday. Based on this interpretation, Abu Hurairah, Ibn Abbas, Qatada, Malik ibn Dinar, Ad-Dahak, Abu Razin, Abu Abdurrahman, Humayd and Ibn Muayyin state that the coming of the Prophet Jesus will indeed be one of the signs of doomsday. In his commentary, Tabari interprets the verse thus. The appearance of the Prophet Jesus is a sign revealing the coming of the hour of doomsday. That is because his appearance is one of the signs of doomsday. His descent to earth is proof that the end of the world has come, and of the beginning of the hereafter. God knows best, of course. He will teach him the book and wisdom, and the Torah and the Gospel. Remember when God said, Jesus, Son of Mary, remember my blessing to you and to your mother when I reinforced you with the purest spirit so that you could speak to people in the cradle and when you were fully grown, and when I taught you the book and wisdom, and the Torah and the Gospel. The verse reveals that God will teach Jesus the book, the Torah and the Gospel. Obviously, this book in question is very important. When we examine other verses in the Quran, we see that the term book refers to the Quran. In this case, the Quran is the third book that Jesus will be taught. But this will be possible only when he returns to earth, for he lived approximately 600 years before the Quran's revelation. It is therefore impossible for him to have learned the Quran during the time at which he lived. It is also revealed in the hadiths of our Prophet, may God bless him and grant him peace, that when the Prophet Jesus returns, he will rule not with the Bible, but with the Quran. He will lead you according to the book of your Lord and the Sunnah of your Apostle. In short, the Prophet Jesus will return to earth and will learn the Quran at that time. There is no doubt but that God knows the truth. The likeness of Jesus in God's sight is the same as Adam. The likeness of Jesus in God's sight is the same as Adam. It is also possible that this verse, too, refers to the return of the prophet Jesus. Muslim scholars who have written Quranic commentaries point out that this verse indicates the fact that both prophets did not have a father, for God created both of them with the command, "Be." However, the verse could also have another meaning. Just as Adam was sent down to earth from God's presence, Jesus too will be sent down to earth from God's presence. God knows best, of course. The day I was born, the day I die, and the day I am raised up again alive. Peace be upon me the day I was born, the day I die, and the day I am raised up again alive. This verse speaks of the day on which he will die. This death can only be possible after he returns and lives on earth for a period of time. Of course, only God knows for certain. You could speak to people in the cradle, and when you were fully grown. Remember when God said, "Jesus, Son of Mary, remember my blessing to you and to your mother when I reinforced you with the purest spirit so that you could speak to people in the cradle and when you were fully grown." He will speak to people in the cradle, and also when fully grown, and will be one of the righteous. Kalam, which is used only in these two verses, only in reference to Jesus, and to express Jesus' adulthood, means someone between the age of 30 and 50, someone who is no longer young, someone who has reached the perfect age. Islamic scholars agree that it denotes the age of 35 or above. Yet, based on hadiths, they state that Jesus was raised up to God's presence in his early 30s. Therefore, the prophet Jesus did not reach the age of Kalan during his first life. This may also indicate that he will return again to earth and live a second life. In the commentary of At-Tabari, Imam At-Tabari gives the following explanation of these verses. These statements indicate that in order to complete his lifespan and speak to people when fully grown, Jesus will come down from heaven. That is because he was raised to heaven when still young. Jesus will be recognized by the fact that he will have no relatives and that no one will know him. In Surah 3, verse 45, God informs us that the prophet Jesus is of high esteem in the world and the hereafter, and one of those brought near. Thus, like all the prophets, Jesus will be known to those people surrounding him for the honor and excellence only seen in those chosen by God. Those who see him will recognize him at first sight, and there will be no doubt on this matter in their hearts. Apart from these, there will also be other factors disclosing his identity. No doubt, one of them will be the fact that he will have no relatives, family, or acquaintances on earth.
Eskiden tanıdığı tek bir kişinin olmamasıdır.